While President Trump's battle for the wall continues in Washington, a group of Catholics along the Rio Grande River pray they don't lose their cherished 19th century chapel. White House correspondent Mark Irons joins us with that story from Mission, Texas. Good evening, Mark.
While La Lomita Chapel behind me has been serving this community for more than 100 years. Now, Mission, Texas was actually named after the chapel's founding by missionaries, the Oblates of Mary Immaculate. People come here to pray, celebrate masses, baptisms, weddings. But these days, churchgoers fear that a border wall could cut them off from a holy place.
Mass begins before sunrise.
And help us always to show your kindness to strangers.
As a candlelit congregation of longtime churchgoers huddles together at La Lomita Chapel. Some 50 yards from this holy site, the Rio Grande River levee, where President Trump's border wall could one day stand. The barrier would separate U.S. churchgoers on one side, the chapel on the other. The local Brownsville diocese isn't waiting for that day, pushing back in court now. And even if the government paid for the land, one man isn't interested.
We could raffle off a truck and make that kind of money. We don't want to sell our mother's church, our holy mother. That wouldn't work for us at all.
Some call him the cowboy priest. Father Roy Snipes is a willing fighter for La Lomita, having overseen the chapel for more than 20 years.
It's a sacred place, but evidently they're already telling us, we want your place. Thank you for coming, y'all.
Right now, the U.S. government is arguing a preliminary survey of the land wouldn't violate the rights of visitors, but these longtime La Lomita regulars have seen the wall go up in different parts of South Texas and can imagine a future structure infringing on their right to worship.
We feel angry that we wouldn't be able to have direct access to it.
It's scary and it's sad.
The first start is always a little tricky.
Father Roy has heard President Trump declare a crisis on the border, but he says the nearby Rio Grande River that divides Mexico and the U.S. gives him peace.
The Catholic Church allows countries to secure their borders if it's for the good of the people in their country. Do you think that's not needed here?
No. I don't think anybody would say we should just have an open border. I think everybody would say we ought to work something out.
But a wall here, he says, is not the solution. If President Trump's plans become reality, La Lomita Chapel would end up in what Father Roy calls a no-man's land, stuck between the Rio Grande and the border wall. So, what would he say to the president?
Listen to the Spirit. The Spirit's got something to tell you, and I don't think this is it.
And Wyatt, to update you on the legal proceedings surrounding this case, just this week, the government told a judge that the church's challenge is premature because the government hasn't decided how to use this land. And taking possession, they say, would not cause a, quote, substantial burden on the diocese's exercise of its religious beliefs. Of course, Wyatt, the diocese isn't backing down.
White House correspondent Mark Irons reporting from Mission, Texas. Thanks, Mark.